Diets, they don't work. The diet industry, billions and billions and billions of dollars, and they still try to say, reduce your calories, that's the best way. I would say for you to look into fasting a little bit, and I know what you're thinking. Oh my God, I can't even miss a meal without almost wanting to obliterate myself. I understand that, but give it a chance. Realistically, when you stop eating, your body has to get into the reserves of fuel. Well, that's that fat that you don't want to have anymore. So that's what I ended up doing to torch off 135 pounds of body fat. It wasn't easy. It took a lot of practice going from eating all the time, way overfed, going from binging to nothing, going from being on autopilot for a majority of my adult life, just eating without any cause, or eating without any reservation, eating without any thought. I just ate, and it was an addiction. And me trying to find some kind of emotional fulfillment through food. And I've noticed that I'm an addictive type. So I have to be incredibly careful when it comes to everything I subject myself to. Now, fitness and that realm has become a new addiction, but hopefully somewhat healthier. But I'm not taking it to an extreme either, where I'm base jumping and doing all this other fancy stuff. I really like the way that I've become, so I'm going to stay that way. The change at the beginning was really that of education, because everybody says, well, if you restrict your calories, then you're going to burn muscle. Then people say, well, if you fast, you're going to burn muscle. So what I was able to do is I looked at the entire equation, and I wasn't so concerned with losing really any muscle. I wanted to focus on losing the fat, as most people want to. The difference is, I was listening to these trainers online and all these dietary nutritionists online that have never been fat. They've never been obese, let alone obese for over 40 years of their lives, having that impact them on a daily basis. And then in their 50s, well, this is what happened to me. In my 50s, I started to see where those changes, me being so fat for so long, were starting to have a physical and a health impact. Now, of course, it's always been physical, where it's been difficult to move, it's been difficult to put on pants, it's been difficult to cut my toenails, it's been just difficult. Once I was able to get a majority of the fat off, that's when I started to realize how worth it the sacrifice of not eating for extended periods of time was. It's going to take you practicing not eating. And yes, after a while, you'll realize it. In fact, you've probably already done it. You just haven't really realized it. Have you ever been busy? Maybe at work, maybe you have a project due, maybe you have something else that you're working on, maybe you're with your kids. All of a sudden, you go an entire day and you realize, I haven't even eaten today. Well, your mind was so occupied with all of the other to-do items, you didn't have a concern, nor did your body even care. That's what happens when you start to practice the fasting. I would say this, once you get into an area where you're able to put the fork down for 2 or 3 or 4 days in a row, and then that first breakfast meal or the breakfast meal you have is done very sensibly in control, and you space out the next several meals just to make sure that you are honoring your body with the food that you're putting in, because you haven't had any for a few days, you're honoring your body, you're slowly ingesting this food, but you're doing it in a very controlled and a very focused manner. That, ladies and gentlemen, is when you know that you've conquered being fat. You've been able to get that in your mind where it's okay not to eat food for a few days, and then once you resume, you don't blow it out of the water by buying an extra large pizza. You actually take it slow, maybe drink a little bit of bone broth, because understand, you just shut down your digestive system probably for the first time in your entire life. More than likely, you've probably been way overfed because you're fat, as I was way overfed because I was fat. Your body does something with those excess calories if it can't burn it, because you don't have the ability to burn 10,000 calories a day unless you're going to basically obliterate yourself and work out crazily for 24-hour segments day after day after day, which we can't do. Your body is going to hold on to those excessive calories in the way of fat, and it's going to put it everywhere. To get rid of that isn't easy. You have to tap into it for energy. Your body stores it. It's an incredible mechanism. Your body also understands why it's being stored, for the times you don't have it. So if you don't have food, your body ends up going to your fat reserves. Once it goes there, then it starts to burn through that. The problem is we as a world are instantaneous in gratification. We don't want to wait. We want to have it all happen. But ladies and gentlemen, what burns fat faster than not eating anything, having no caloric content whatsoever for multiple days in a row? Now, you're going to have to ask your doctor, ask your medical professional before you jump into any kind of fasting. However, I would suggest that you talk to them a little bit about if you're 130 pounds too fat, which I was. I had an over 64-inch waist. I was massive when I first started this. The doctors even recommended the book Obesity Code by Jason Fung. I read through it. After I did succeed, however, and went back and wanted to thank the doctor, they had no idea what I was talking about because it's not popular medical opinion to not eat for extended periods of time because there are a lot of other considerations that you need to have. If you're taking medicine and you're not eating for a few days, how does that work in your body? If you are on a trip or on a vacation or you have a certain method, how does that work not eating around other people? That's a big deal, folks. And if you don't expect somebody to have a problem with you not eating at the dinner table, think again. It's going to happen. My suggestion is you let everybody know if you try to attempt to drop off or torch body fat time after time after time and everybody around you has lost complete faith in your ability, you're going to have to ask them and maybe tell them, hey, I'm doing this for me. I'm giving this a shot for me. And it's going to be uncomfortable. And I know the dinner table is where everybody goes. I know the restaurants where we go to have camaraderie with one another and connect as those tribes that we are. However, folks, consider this. If you put it down for just a little while and repeat the process, and maybe Monday through Wednesday you don't eat, and you're torching off your body fat, and the next 4 days you eat sensibly, after a while it's going to become something that you just do. And then everybody around you is going to say, oh my gosh, look at this. This cat was 365 pounds. Now he's about 230, 240, and he's lost all this fat, and he actually sits down at the dinner table and doesn't have to eat anything. Maybe has some sparkling water, maybe sits there and jokes and laughs and has a great time. But again, it's going to be up to your own process, your own decisions, and your own being true to yourself. Here's a final word. Don't be too difficult on yourself if, in fact, you hang it up early. I know this is said a lot, but probably not harped on as much as it needs to be. You owe it to yourself to give yourself a break. It's not easy getting where you've been. You've had to overeat for years and years and years to get all that fat on your frame. Well, now it's time to start using it for beautifully structured meals by not eating, because that's what you end up doing. You end up eating perfect meals off of your own stored body fat. And in fact, you will drop that body fat a lot faster than you could with caloric restriction. And also from the studies I've read, you're going to preserve a lot more muscle by not eating at all. Then there's other types of fasting. Now, it doesn't stop with water fasting, just drinking water only. Maybe you don't drink any water or have any food. That's known as dry fasting. That's something to also research. Online research for that, dryfastingclub.com. Never met the gentleman, but he does have some good content. And of course, Berg and DeLauer and Funk and these folks online, even Set Guru and these other people, talk about cessation from food. Us as human beings, we're overfed, way overwatered, and sometimes we just need a break to reset everything. Fasting was my trick. That was my method, and that's what really worked for me. Maybe it will for you too. Just envelop it, take it out for a little test drive, kick the tires, keep the dirt off of it, see if you like it, and it probably will work for you. I'm Connor with Honor. I'll be back with another one.